Hey everybody, it's Mr. Josh, and today I'm doing this video from my workshop, and I have my garage, it's in my wood shop, and I think you can see some of that behind me, some of the tools and fun things that I get to do, and some of the things that help me do my job. And today, I thought we'd do it from here, have fun with it. I hope that you're enjoying your break, and I know many of you now are done with school and done with classes, and so your summer break has begun. It's probably really great not having to do school every day on the computer, or with your videos, or however that was that you were doing it. And I hope now that for the next 3 months, things will get a little bit back to normal for you. And hopefully soon, we as a class will be able to get back to normal too. And I don't know when that'll be and when we'll be allowed to do that. I know that as a church, we've been able to go on Sunday mornings, and I've seen many of you there. And hopefully soon, we'll be able to have class together also. Now, I thought today we'd start off with three songs. These three we've sung before, so I think you know them. We're going to start off with the first one, My God is So Big. Let's sing that one together. Ready? Let's go. Great job. The next song that we're going to sing is He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. Let's sing it together. He's got the whole world in His hands. This last song I need you to get up out of your seats for, because this one's got some great motions and I know you know them. Let's sing I've Got Peace Like a River, Love Like an Ocean, Joy Like a Fountain. Out of your seats, let's do this one together and have a lot of fun singing this song, I've Got Peace Like a River.
I've got peace like a river.
ahead and pull out your Bibles if you have one of those in front of you. If you know where it is there in your room or close by, why don't you go ahead and get that? Because we're going to look at the Bible verses found in 1 Thessalonians chapter number 5. And I believe we've talked about these verses before, and we're going to look at it from a different part of the verse here today than we have in the past. But 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, and look at verse number 16. 1 Thessalonians 5, that's in the New Testament. It's one of the smaller books, but if you see the Timothy's and Thessalonians, they're right next to each other. 1 Thessalonians, the one with the one in front of it, chapter number 5, verse number 16 through 18. You read it, and I'm going to say it here together. It says, "Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." And there's two phrases in there, and one main phrase that we're going to talk about. That phrase, the first one, rejoice evermore. And then that second one, in everything give thanks. In everything give thanks, because the Bible says that this is God's will. It's what God desires for us. It's what God desires for you, what God desires for me. That in everything, whatever the situation, the thing that happens in your life, whether it's a good thing that we can be excited about, whether it's a bad thing, maybe that makes us sad or that maybe makes us unhappy or even mad, God says in all those things, we need to give thanks to Him and learn to recognize that God is in control and God wants us to give thanks for all the things that He has done. As we begin, let's start with a word of prayer and then we'll talk about these two things and what they mean for you and for me. You ready? Father in heaven, we love you. We are so very thankful for the Word of God that you've given to us and that you desire to have a part and a path in every one of our lives. Lord, from the 5-year-olds who are listening to the 12-year-olds who are listening and everyone in between, Lord, for me and for every adult and parent who's listening as well, God, may we, in these situations that we find ourselves in, whether the big picture, the things going on in the world, or, Lord, every single thing that happens in every one of these child's lives, may we, Father, learn to trust you. And we pray this in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. God tells us to rejoice evermore. That means always. To always find reason or to always give thanks, to always rejoice. Sometimes that's easy. Sometimes it's our birthday. Hey, it's a great day to rejoice. We can rejoice over the gifts that are coming in and the friends that are over and the cake that we're having. It's our birthday. You got to graduate to that next number. Maybe your parents threw a party or you got to have some kind of celebration at the end of your school year when you finished first grade or fifth grade and you get to rejoice that you're finally done with those classes and you get to move on to the next grade. Those are great things to rejoice, to be happy and excited about. God desires that we would have that joy, though, not just when we're excited over the good things, but He says, evermore, always, to rejoice all the time, to have a joy bubbling out of our hearts all of the time. Now, Miss Anna is known for always having a smile on her face. There is a joy that is always a part of Miss Anna. And you guys love her for that. She's the most friendly person that I know because she has a rejoicing always. And you know, sometimes though, we're going to come to a situation. Maybe it's just a bad day. Maybe something that you really wanted to happen isn't going to happen anymore. Maybe something that you were very much excited about got canceled. Maybe someone that you were going to go to see, they can't see you anymore. Maybe somebody said something unkind to you that hurt your feelings. Maybe you got hurt. Maybe you're just playing outside and something bad happened that just made you sad. And I know that our emotions and our heart says, yeah, this is sad and I'm going to be sad over this. But even when things sometimes happen not the way that we want them to, or they don't go the way that we plan, God says to in those things to rejoice. And in that third verse, verse 18, He says, in everything give thanks. For this is God's will. God wants us to have a joy, a bubbling excitement over our life. but also to find things to give thanks for. Maybe it's something that happened bad, but you can give thanks that there's something else that you get to do. Maybe something didn't go your way, but you can give thanks that maybe it helps somebody else. Maybe you wanted to pick the person on the team, or you wanted to play a certain game, but you can give thanks just that you're able to play with your brothers or sisters or play with your friends. God wants us, it's His will, His desire, God's heart for us, is that we would learn to give thanks. Always, in all the things of our life, learn to give thanks for them. So boys and girls, God wants us to rejoice, to have a joy, to be excited for His work, His plan, His way in our lives. And then He tells us to give thanks. Give thanks. Look for opportunities. Look for the good. Look for those things that we can praise God, give thanks to God for. It's not always easy. I'll tell you what, I'm not the best at it all the time. But this is God's will. And as I grow as a Christian, and as I become more like Christ, then I'm going to want to find things myself to give thanks for. And you, as you grow to be more like Christ, and as you follow God's will, boys and girls, He wants the same for you. Not to be grumpy, not to be critical, not to always be upset or angry, but rather what God wants and what we are, what we are doing when we're more like Him is that we are rejoicing with a joy and a smile on our faces, and that we are giving thanks for the good things and the bad things that happen sometimes in our lives. So when you're sad, don't let that sadness overcome you. Don't let it be how you become known and just mess and mope around and be upset. But rather find the thing that you can give thanks for, even in your sadness. And you will be glad. You will be filled with joy because you're going to be more like Christ. And that's what God is desiring. And that's what He's going to bless and work and do great things through in your life. So boys and girls, remember those two things. Rejoice always and give thanks in all things. God's pretty clear what He wants us to do, how He wants us to be. So let's have a better attitude, a good attitude, just as our Savior Jesus did. So boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. And until we see you again, maybe we'll see you in church on Sunday morning. Maybe we'll be able to have junior church soon, something we can pray for. Until we do, I'm going to love you. Let me or you let Miss Anna know if there's anything you guys want to share with us or tell us about. We'd love to hear about it. Love to hear from some of you. See how you're doing and how you're going now through the spring into your summer. And you let us know what's going on. Can't wait to see you again. All right, guys. Have a great one. Bye. All right. I got to wipe my face. I am sweating. So as we begin.